Hi guys, welcome to Tutes Online. Today I'll be talking about nodal analysis. Nodal analysis is a useful method for analyzing a circuit and is based on KCL, KVL, and Ohm's law. Nodal analysis is used to find the voltage at a node. Start off with a basic circuit. So here's our basic circuit. We're given a few values. There's a 5 volt source, 10 milliamp source, and 2 resistors. So the first step in nodal analysis is to label parameters. We'll call this V1, this one R2 and R1, and we'll call this I2. Step 2 is to choose our reference voltage. So this is the voltage which is essentially ground. It's called a reference voltage or a common voltage. So we'll say this is our reference voltage, and that's usually chosen to be the negative terminal of the supply. Step 3, assign voltage labels. So this is the label for the voltage nodes. We'll call this one V1, this node here, and this one can be V2. So you can see all of this is at the same potential, all of this is at the same potential, and all of this is at the same potential as well. But this is 0 volts because it's our ground, and so we won't bother labeling it. Step 4 is to identify our unknown voltages. So in our case, this is only V2. We already know that V1 would be equal to the voltage source here. So V1's known, V2 is unknown. Step 5 is to write out the KCL equations. So our Kirchhoff's current law. And we only need to do this for our unknown one. So we'll write our current arrows. So our arrows for the current direction are leaving this node. You know that it'll be going this way because the arrow on the current source here is this way. And for these ones, we just chose a value. So our KCL equation on this would be, on the first one, we know it's I2. So the current going this way, plus the current going through this resistor. So that's V2 minus 0 over R1, so the difference in potential divided by the resistance, V equals IR. But because it's minus 0, we could just write V2 over R1. And this is plus V2 minus V1, the difference in potential between these two points, divided by the resistance there, which is R2. And the summation of these currents should be 0. So because we have only one unknown voltage, there's only one equation, so step 6 is just to solve. So we'll substitute in our values. We know that I2 is 10 milliamps, so that's 10 milliamps plus V2, we don't know that, divided by R1, that's 10k, plus V2 minus V1. We know V1, that's 5 volts, divided by R2, which is 2 kilo ohms, and this equals 0. So we have a common denominator of 10k, so we'd have 10m times by 10k, essentially the k and m cancel, plus V2 plus 10k divided by 2k, so that'll just be a 5 out the front, V2 minus 5 equals 0. So this is 100 plus V2 plus 5 V2 minus 25 equals 0, which is 6 V2 equals minus 75, or V2 equals minus 12.5. And so that's our answer for the voltage, and the unit is volts. We'll now look at a harder example, because you often don't have just one unknown voltage. So this is our circuit. We're given a few values, and we'll label our parameters. We'll call that R1, R2, R3, R4, call this one I1 and I2, and we'll label our voltage nodes. So we'll call this V1, V2, and V3, and our reference is just down here. So we'll jump straight to doing the KCL at V1. The current will be going this way, and so we'd have I1 plus the voltage difference across the resistor, which is V2 minus V1 over R1, and that's equal to zero. For V2, we have the voltage drop across V1, which we just found out before, so that's V2 minus V1 over R1. We'll say the current's going down here and along here, plus the voltage drop across R2, which is V2 over R2, plus the voltage drop across R3, which is V2 minus V3 divided by R3. That equals zero. And for our final node, V3, the KCL would be our current. We know this current's going up this way. We'll say this one's going down here. And we've already said this one's going this way. So we'd have I1 plus the voltage drop across R4, which is V3 divided by R4, and the voltage drop across R3, which would be V2 minus V3 divided by R3. This equals zero. So substituting our known values, getting our common denominator, and simplifying these equations, we get V1 minus V2 equals 150. For this one, we get 4V2 minus V1 minus 2V3 equals 0. For the last one, it's 3V3 minus 4V2 equals 40. So to get a solution to all these, we need to use Cramer's rule. So we'll write these in a way that we can put them in a matrix. So for the first one, it's V1 minus V2 plus, we don't have a V3, so we'll call it 0V3 equals 150. For the next one, it's minus V1 plus 4V2 minus 2V3 equals 0. For the last one, it's 0V1 minus 4V2 plus 3V3 equals 40. And putting all this in matrix form, we'd get 1 minus 1, 0, minus 1, 4, minus 4, 0, minus 2, 3. So that's just the coefficients of these. Our voltages, which is V1, V2, V3, and the solutions, which is 150, 0, and 40. So now we have to find the determinant of this. We'll call it the A matrix. And so the determinant of A we'd get by doing 1 times by 4 times by 3 minus 4, minus 4 I should say, times by 2, it's minus 1 times by minus 1 times by 3, 0 times by 2, minus 2 I should say, plus 0 times by something. But it's equal to zero, so it doesn't matter. And if you solve all that, you should get a determinant equal to 1. So to find our V1, V2, and V3 value, we need to replace the first, second, and third column by the solution to the matrix. So I'll show you what I mean. So V1 equals our column matrix solution here, which is 150, 0, 4, and then the rest of the matrix here. So from the second and third column, we've got minus 1, 4, minus 4, 0, minus 2, 3, and we divide this by our determinant. So that's divided by 1. So it doesn't mean much in this case, but if your determinant wasn't 1, it's a bit more important. For V2, we'd get 1, minus 1, 0, so that's the first column. We'll replace the second column with 150, 0, 40, then 0, minus 2, 3, and divide by our determinant. For V3, we have 1, minus 1, 150, minus 1, 4, 0, 0, minus 4, 40, divided by 1. So solving these, we look at the determinant of this. So if you work that out, you'll get 680 divided by our old determinant, which is 1. So that's 680 volts for V1. V2 is 530 volts. And V3 is 720 volts. And so that's the solution of the voltage at our nodes. So you can do a spot check if you want to check if the solution makes sense. So if we go up to our circuit, if you look here across R1, you know V equals IR. So that means that V1 minus V2 would be equal to our 15 milliamps times by 10K. So this side's equal to 150. And so this side should be 150 as well. We just found that 680 was V1 minus V2, which is 530. The difference between those two is 150. And so our solution makes sense, at least for V1 and V2. You can check it for V2 and V3 if you like as well. So that's how you do nodal analysis. If you have any questions, post a comment. Please subscribe and visit the website. Thanks.